Hi everyone, this is Dr. Nitin Choda with Ignition Time and welcome to my channel. If you don't know anything about me, please check out my video. You'll learn more about who I am, what my journey has been like and why you should listen to me. Also, if you learn something new from this video, please consider clicking the like button. Please also subscribe and enable notifications so you get instant updates from our channel going forward. The name of our channel is Ignition Time. Now, a video like this is difficult, is challenging for me to make because the data is pretty disturbing. But the reason I started this channel is I want to provide honest news. I want to provide the truth to my viewers and subscribers. I don't want to give you false hope. Trust me, I'd be happy. I'd love to report good news, and I'm positive I will be reporting good news soon. But at this moment in time, the news was just released and this was just announced. You'll see this article on your screen from the New York Times. 8 million individuals have slipped into poverty since May as the federal aid has dried up. In fact, with the CARES Act, the poverty rates actually declined because the CARES Act was a significant infusion of money. With the stimulus checks, with the $600 a week unemployment booster, poverty actually dropped because people use that money to be able to pay off debt. People use that money in order to be able to buy food, to buy groceries. Did some people waste money? Sure, that happens in any system, in any society. But now, since the federal aid dried up, the poverty levels have actually gone up higher than what they were compared to the pre-pandemic levels. This is quite shocking. In fact, the New York Times article highlighted Richard Musa and his wife Kristen Jeffcoat with their children, and they live in California. And when schools closed in the spring, Ms. Jeffcoat, who's an Instacart shopper, meaning when the Instacart shopper goes shopping, the shop actually buys stuff for other individuals as well. That's what an Instacart shopper is. So Ms. Jeffcoat stayed at home to watch their children, and then the husband got laid off from his landscaping job. This is just astonishing. Here's some data from the New York Times article, and the article says that after the CARES Act, millions of individuals were actually indeed saved from poverty as a direct result of the CARES Act. Now, I want to be clear, there is a significant difference between the two studies when it comes to the most recent month, the month of September. The Columbia model showed an improvement in poverty in the month of September, whereas the Chicago and Notre Dame study found that poverty continued to grow in the month of September. Now, here's the thing. At its peak in May, the aid, the financial aid from the CARES Act that was passed in March, kept more than 18 million individuals from poverty. This was found by the Columbia researchers. But by September, presumably because the $600 a week unemployment booster expired at the end of July, so the real impact was felt late in August and early September, that number had fallen to about 4 million. In other words, significantly more individuals became poor. Now, according to Zachary Parolin, who's an author of the Columbia analysis, he said, and I quote, "The CARES Act was unusually successful, but now it's gone and a lot more people are poor." Now, let me define poverty as far as this New York Times article is concerned. A family of four living in a typical city is considered poor if their annual income, the combined annual income, is less than $28,170. So that is considered the definition of poverty, again, for a family of four living in a typical city. Let's take the example of a couple that were actually highlighted in this New York Times article. And I just have to warn you, this is a tough story, but I do want to present my viewers and subscribers with all the facts. Kristen Jeffcoat, who's 24 years old, is raising three children in California. When schools closed last spring, Ms. Jeffcoat, who like I said, is an Instacart shopper. So when the Instacart shopper goes shopping, they buy food for other families as well. So so that's what they do. So Ms. Jeffcoat stayed home to watch them. Then her husband got laid off from her landscaping job. Now, this is where things get worse. The expanded safety net initially did help them. You know, when the money came in from the CARES Act, together they received more than $1,500 a week in jobless benefits, which actually exceeded their lost wages. They also received a $3,900 stimulus check, which they used to prepay 3 months of rent. This was at the start of the year. But since the unemployment bonus ended in the month of July, their cash income has fallen nearly 80% because they were dependent on this aid from the government. Now they are living on $350 a week plus food stamps. And Ms. Jeffcoat and her husband have actually gone without electricity because they cannot afford generator fuel. Now they live in a house that's off the power grid, and they've spent weeks without propane for cooking and hot showers. It's tough for me to read stories like this. So they said, "We stick with hot meals and cereals." That's what Ms. Jeffcoat said. To feed the children, Ms. Jeffcoat said she sometimes skips meals, especially at the end of the month when the food stamps have run out. Her husband sold his tools to buy diapers, and Ms. Jeffcoat tried to sell her eggs to a fertility clinic. but she did not medically qualify. Worse than the physical hardships is the worry, is the concern, is the stress that they're going through right now. She said, I quote, I've definitely found myself feeling a little anxious, snappier with the children. You know, so income volatility, losing income is especially hard for low income families, especially families that don't have savings. The stress, the potential depression that kicks in is another, it's almost like a double whammy for families that have no savings. Now, I do want to be clear, the significant stimulus from the CARES Act did not reach everybody. According to this article, the aid expansion did not reach everyone. About a third of individuals who are unemployed still do not receive unemployment checks. This was reported by the Columbia analyst. Some jobless people are unaware that they can apply, some encounter red tape, some make mistakes with their unemployment benefits application, some just are stuck in the quagmire of the unemployment benefits system, which has been completely overloaded. Many unemployment benefit systems have not been updated in 40, 50 years. And so that's a problem with the unemployment benefit system. As far as the stimulus checks go, among individuals eligible for stimulus checks, about 30% fail to receive them. I see viewers and subscribers in our comment section who say that they have still not got a stimulus check. This was an estimate from the Columbia researchers. Most families receive stimulus checks automatically, but those who are too poor to file tax returns had to go through some additional steps and had to reapply because they did not get their stimulus checks. Now, I do want to be clear to my viewers and subscribers, the CARES Act was very successful. The Paycheck Protection Program helped. The $1,200 stimulus checks helped. The $600 a week unemployment benefit booster helped. All of these things helped a lot. But what these things did was that as soon as these things ended, they exposed the glaring inadequacies, the unfairness of our system. They exposed the K-shaped recovery where some individuals have recovered and some individuals have essentially been left behind because they don't have any savings. In fact, here's some more crucial information from this article. This crisis is hitting minorities especially hard, preserving or even deepening the large poverty gaps that predated the pandemic. The analysts at Chicago and Notre Dame found that poverty amongst African American individuals was rising at an especially fast pace at a time when, you know, when the whole economy is struggling and is going through an uneven recovery. Here's what's interesting. African American individuals and Latinos are more than twice as likely as white individuals to be poor, according to the new data. Both minority groups, meaning African Americans and Latinos, disproportionately work in industries that have been hit hardest by the recession. And so we're talking about travel, entertainment, leisure, and hospitalities. Here's another interesting thing. African American individuals, according to this study, disproportionately live in southern states, which have lower unemployment benefits and lower benefits overall, and some Latinos are disqualified because they lack legal status, according to this article. Quite an astonishing situation we have here. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. If you learned something new from this video, please, 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 please consider clicking the like button. Please share this video with friends and family. That is your vote of confidence in me and my team and all the work that goes into this channel, that goes behind the scenes in creating this content and making it nice and easy to consume, and all the editing work that goes into these videos. Please again consider clicking like, please subscribe, and please enable notifications so you get instant updates from our channel going forward. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. I hope you learned something new. My name is Dr. Nitin Choda with Ignition Time. If you don't know anything about me, please check out my video. You'll learn more about who I am, what my journey has been like, and why you should listen to me. Remember, we release videos at 2 p.m. East Coast time most days of the week. That's 2 p.m. East Coast time. You can get your cell phone out, send a text message with the word Ignition or with the word time to 70,000, that's 70000, and then you'll get added to SMS alerts list. Now, if you want, you can also get on our email list. Simply go to ignitiontime.com/alerts. That's ignitiontime.com/alerts, and you'll get added to our email list going forward. Sometimes YouTube does not send out email notifications or notifications through the app. So what you can do is simply bookmark youtube.com/ignitiontime. That's youtube.com/ignitiontime. And then that way you're not dependent on notifications and you can check out the homepage of our channel for all our latest videos. You're never going to miss a single video and you can watch it at your convenience. Now, you can also follow us on Instagram. Simply go to ignition_time on Instagram. Find us on Instagram at ignition_time. That's our handle. And you can get exclusive content on Instagram. You can also follow us on Twitter Our Twitter handle is also ignition_time. That's ignition_time. You'll get breaking news and alerts from us on Twitter. So we look forward to growing with you on Twitter. Also, please click like on our video. If you learn something new, please ignite the subscribe button. Remember, the name of our channel is Ignition Time, and also enable notifications so you get instant updates from us going forward. Remember, once again, we release videos at 2 p.m. East Coast time most days of the week. All the links to our sources, to our new sources, are always found in the description section below. If you learn something new from this video, please consider clicking like, please subscribe, please enable notifications, and also please comment below and participate with us and engage with us in our growing community. We find that our community, which is growing, which is respectful, which is consists of highly astute, highly intelligent individuals, is a very valuable part of what we have to offer as our channel. And oftentimes, I think you'll get valuable insight from our community, oftentimes more so than what you get in the videos, because I think the collective insight of the community is significantly greater than what I can offer you. Thank you so much. I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next episode of Ignition Time. Take care. Bye.